So today is my birthday, my 28th birthday. I am 28 years old, you guys. Hi, welcome back to Humble Homemaking. We are in a different room than we normally are because my son is out in the living room watching a movie and I don't want to disturb him. So I decided to come into my workout room and record, and I'm kind of liking it a little bit better because I have these cool lights on the wall and the lighting is a little bit better in here. So I don't know if this might be my new background, but we'll see. I did take the tapestry down because it was very distracting, very colorful and bright, and I like the plain background a lot better. I thought it would be a really cool thing today to do 28 things I've learned in my 28 years of life. So anyways, let's get into the video. The first lesson I've learned in my 28 years of life is to listen to understand, don't listen to respond. This means when you're talking to somebody, to actually listen to them. Just listen and take a few seconds to understand where they're coming from before you respond. In a world where everybody is so fixated and focused on themselves, it is just nice for the other person to realize that people do want to listen to them and understand them rather than listen to give a response or a comment. Second thing I've learned in life is to not let my past define me. If you've watched my testimony video, know that I came from a lot and experienced a lot in my life, and I don't let that define me. I do use those experiences as knowledge for other people and as a way of relating to others and letting others know that I'm not perfect. I truly use my past as life lessons and experience. The third thing I've learned in my 28 years of life is that getting out of my safe space and actually living is so beneficial. Sitting in my safe space, in my little comfort zone, where I know I'm untouched and I know that I'm okay and safe, is fine, but it's boring. And getting out and experiencing life and facing my fears has brought me so much joy. It has brought me so many great people and so many great things. For example, I wanted to make a YouTube channel for years now. I love talking about things, about experiences, and about things I'm knowledgeable in and things that I'm opinionated about, but I always let fear hold me back. So I sat in my comfort zone and I was like, no, I'm not gonna talk about this. I'm not going to make a YouTube channel because what if I get a lot of hate comments, or what if this, or what if that? And you know what? I pushed myself out of my comfort zone and I don't regret this one bit. My community is still pretty small on here and that's okay, but I pushed myself out of my comfort zone, out of my safe space, and I'm doing something that I've always wanted to do, and I'm not letting fear get in the way because fear is a liar. If I didn't get out of my safe space, I would have never met Cole, and I would have never had Atlas. I would have never had this life that I'm living right now if I didn't get out of my safe space. Thank God that I was pushed out of my comfort zone to be able to do the things that I've always wanted to do and to be able to experience life and truly live. The fourth thing I've learned is you are who you surround yourself with. Now, in my life, I've surrounded myself with not so great people and really great people. I will say this again probably in a future video, but if you hang out at the barbershop long enough, you're going to get a haircut. If I'm sitting around with a bunch of people who, for lack of a better term, aren't aligned with what I value in life, then I might start going down the same path as them, and I might value the same things that they value, which I just don't want that. So in the process of coming to Christ and truly turning my life around, I've lost friendships, and you know, losing a close friendship hurts. I'm not going to lie, it hurts. But honestly, some of those friendships needed to be separated because I wasn't benefiting from them, and together we were bad apples. Surrounding myself with people who value the same things as I do brings so much value into my life. The fifth thing I've learned in life is to slow down, be frugal, and decrease clutter. Slowing down in your life. In this fast-paced world where there's new cell phones coming out every single year with bigger, better cameras, and faster this and faster that, everything is so fast-paced, fashion is so fast-paced, entertainment is fast-paced, social media is fast-paced. Slowing down in life helps decrease my anxiety so much because I'm not sitting here trying to keep up with everybody. I'm just going at my own pace and I'm just enjoying the things that I have. I don't have the latest, greatest cell phone or a fancy camera setup. I've learned to be frugal in my life. Being frugal has saved me so much money. I would actually say that being frugal is a hobby of mine. It is just so much fun to learn how to budget and do things in a way where I'm not buying new things all the time. And it's really a creativity outlet, being frugal with things and learning how to expand on the things that you already have. And decreasing clutter in my house has also decreased my anxiety. Not only have I decluttered everything physically around me, but I've also decluttered my mind in the process of decluttering my physical environment. A decluttered physical environment declutters your mind. That is something that I'm so happy to have learned. The sixth thing that I've learned in my 28 years of life is that not everyone is going to like you. I always had more people who liked me than the people who didn't like me. I would always get so upset when out of 20 people, 2 people didn't like me, and I would always be like, why don't they like me? What do I need to do? As harsh as this might sound, I love everybody, but I don't like everybody, and we aren't made to like everybody. The seventh thing I've learned is that if you don't like something, change it. So I didn't like my job, so I went to school for personal training. I didn't like that I felt unhealthy and lazy, so I changed it by starting to work out and by eating healthier. And this goes with anything. This is not just physical things. This can be mental things. If I don't like that I keep thinking negatively about myself all the time, I change it. I change my thoughts, I dive deeper into my Bible, which brings me to number 8, which is if you can't change it, then pray on it and change your perspective. So back to the job thing. If you are in a position where you can't change your career, you need to stay in your job, but you don't like your job. You need to change your perspective until you are able to change your situation or until you are able to make a job change. The 9th thing I've learned is that it's okay to say no, and boundaries are a good thing. Boundaries are what keep us safe. Now, this is not a safe space type of thing. So you, on your house, you have 4 walls, right? You feel safe not only from the elements of wind and snow and rain, but you also feel safe because you know you can lock your doors at night and you know that not just anybody can walk up into your house. Those are walls, those are boundaries. Same for personal boundaries. You have to guard your heart. And I used to be a pushover when I was younger. I had a hard time saying no. I had a hard time putting my foot down and telling people how I felt. I was always afraid of them getting mad at me. But I've learned in my 28 years of life that if somebody truly cares about you, they will respect your boundaries. They will respect you if you say no. They will respect how you feel. You can tell somebody no and they don't get mad at you about it. You know that that person is a real one that deserves to be in your life. And if people can't respect your boundaries, then you know that it's time to cut them off. Because if you can't respect boundaries and if you can't respect being told no, you don't respect me as a person. The closest people to me know and understand my boundaries, and I know and understand their boundaries. 10th thing is to start what you've been delaying out of fear. Fear is a liar. I've already said this in number 3, but fear has held me back so many times in my life, so many things that I've finally got to after years of letting fear hold me back, and I've been like, why haven't I done this sooner? I should have done this sooner. I knew I should have started this earlier. I pray on everything before I do something, but I have found that God helps me push through and get past my fears. Number 11 is to be kind to others. Just give and don't expect anything back in return. Just be kind. Don't be kind to somebody and expect them to be kind back to you. Be kind to them. Of course, have your personal boundaries and don't just be a pushover, but be kind. When I was first learning how to establish boundaries with people, I was of course kind to people, but I was kind of like, okay, well, I don't want everybody to walk all over me, so I'm just not gonna do favors for anybody anymore. And I realized that that was actually not helping me because I had always been such a giving person my whole life. So returning back to my roots of being a giving person, not expecting anything back in return, and at the same time, building those boundaries with others has really benefited in my friendships friendships and relationships with people. The 12th thing I've learned is that exercise is a stress reliever and a mood booster. Lifting weights for beginning of 2012, I have been lifting weights and working out and being more conscious of my health. I truly feel a difference when I don't work out versus when I do work out. When I work out, I just feel ready to take on the day. I feel more alert, more awake. I feel like I sleep better at night. I feel stronger both mentally and physically. And when I don't work out, I feel sluggish, lazy, and I don't feel as mentally alert as I do when I do work out. Working out has been such a blessing, especially since finding God, because it's not so much of an aesthetic thing anymore as it is feeling good and taking care of the body that God blessed me with. The 13th thing that I have learned in my life is to forgive and reconcile. Not forgive and forget, because forgiving and forgetting means that you are going to forgive somebody and forget about what they did. And when you forget about something, that means that if something were to happen again and they were to treat you the same way again or say the same thing to you again, well, you forgot what they did. Therefore, it's just like a repeating cycle. Whereas if you reconcile, then you know that you have, once again, those boundaries put in place where you know how this person was in the past. You're going to forgive them. You're going to move past that, but you're not going to forget. You're not going to hold it against them. You're just going to be more cautious. Forgiving and reconciling brings me to number 14, that family can be some of the most toxic people and that you don't have to put up with it. I'm not saying that if you have occasional arguments with a family member that you just have to shut them out of your life. And this doesn't mean that I don't love them. This just means that I have to love them at a distance. I don't have to put up with them. I don't have to just deal with their stuff because they're family. I can set those boundaries, and if they don't want to respect those boundaries, then they are cut out of my life. The 15th thing I've learned in my life is that it's okay to not know something. I used to feel like such a dummy when somebody would ask me a question about something and I didn't know the answer to it. And I've learned that it's okay to not know something. It is better and more intelligent to say, I don't know, than to try and just make up an answer and play along like you know about something when you really don't. It's totally fine to say, I don't know. I don't know, but let's research it together. I don't know, but I'm gonna go home and I'm going to find out. That's a lot better than just trying to pretend, you know? 16th thing I've learned is that money does not buy you happiness, but it can buy you comfort. And this one, I don't want people to take the wrong way. I don't live a luxurious name brand lifestyle, but I will say that money brings me comfort. As long as there is enough money coming in to pay for the roof over my head, the food in my refrigerator and cupboards, the electricity to keep my lights on and my house warm, and the gas to put in the car to go places, then that is more than enough. And I am blessed with the income that we have for our household to sustain us and to give us a comfortable life. The 17th thing that I've learned in my life, and this is kind of a cliche one, but the gratitude attitude. Gratitude attitude is the attitude to have. I've said this before, but if I just look around my house and I find 5 things that I don't like, that's not going to bring me any happiness. That's not going to bring me any joy. So I have to be humble and appreciate everything I have. That gratitude attitude is just the attitude to have. 18th thing I've learned in my life is that God is real and that we should not doubt him. God is so good. My cup runs over because of him, and everything that I am grateful for in my life is because of him. There is not enough thank yous that I could say to show my gratitude for God. Just talking about him makes me tear up. Like, I am just so ashamed that I ever doubted him, because he is amazing and he has brought me so much joy into my life. The 19th thing I've learned in my life is that living to serve others instead of serving myself brings me so much joy. I love cooking for my family. I love cleaning for my family. I love baking for my family. I love doing the small things, making cute little cards for my family, making handmade gifts for my family. I love doing thoughtful things for my family, and that serves me so much more than going online and buying something for myself. That gives me so much purpose. The 20th thing I've learned in my life is the power of learning and reading things from people who are smarter than you and know more than you. It keeps me humble, and it teaches me things in the process, knowing that somebody else is smarter than me. Like, I am so glad that not everybody thinks like I do. I am so glad that not everybody speaks like I do. I am glad that people are smarter than me. Hi, buddy. Leave the door open. Number 21 is, worry is pointless. Give it up to God. I was known my whole life as a worry wart. Even still, I have these worry tendencies where I will ask Cole 20 questions about something because I am nervous and my anxiety is getting to me and I need to know everything. I need to know the who, the what, the why, the where, the when, the how. I need to know it all because I need to mentally prepare myself. And really, doing that sometimes makes me worry more. So I found that if I'm just like, okay, he told me we're gonna do this or we're gonna go here, so I'm just going to trust him and I'm just going to give my worries to God and we're gonna get through this. God always comes through because, like I said, God is good, okay? So give those worries up to God. The 22nd thing I've learned in my 28 years of life is that comparison can stop you from doing things and saying things that are of value to you. This is a whole separate video that I plan on doing on the topic of comparison, but I will just give you a brief little explanation that I used to be a hardcore comparer. I compared myself to everyone and everything, and it was exhausting, and it took a toll on me, and it brought me a lot of anxiety and depression and insecurities. And what that did was stop me from doing and becoming the person that God wants me to become. So, ixnay on the comparison, and wait for that video. Subscribe to my channel and hit the notification bell so that you know when that video goes up. The 23rd thing I've learned in my life is that just because it's trendy doesn't mean it's right. Social media might show you that majority of the people are doing it and that it's socially acceptable, doesn't mean it's right. The mob doesn't rule. Mob rule sucks. So I've learned that truly going against the grain, saying the things that majority doesn't agree with, doing the things that majority of the people don't agree with, brings me more satisfaction and I give all the glory to God. The 24th thing I've learned in my 28 years of life is the beauty of dressing up every day that you can. And this particular one will be in my video about how I embraced my femininity. The explanation of this one and why I learned it will be in my how I embraced my femininity story. Dressing up every single day makes me feel good and ready to take on the day, and I've talked about this in this video. The stereotypical homemaker look, I will link it up here. The 25th thing I've learned in my 28 years of life is that pleasure doesn't equal good. Just because it feels good doesn't mean it's right. I've just learned that pleasure is a temporary satisfaction, and after the pleasure high ends, you usually come down crashing feeling like crap. For example, food. Indulging in multiple sweet things at once, a lot of ice cream and cake and candy might be good in the moment, but in about 30 minutes you're going to have a bellyache, or maybe the next morning you're not going to be able to go to the bathroom properly because your stomach hurts really bad, you know? Avoid pleasure and look for long-term satisfaction. The 26th thing I've learned is that modesty is empowering, which I know some people might think, oh, this top you're wearing today isn't modest, but I feel that my cleavage is not showing, my shoulder is showing, this is a tank top, not a bra, and the sweater is very long and comfy and loose, and so anyways, I'm getting off topic here. Dressing modestly and femininely and comfortably, finding my style and the colors that look good on me, that makes me feel empowered. The 27th thing I've learned is the importance of balance instead of extremes. So instead of saying, well, I'm going to diet and I'm not going to have any of this stuff, I'm going to eat all salads and chicken breast and brown rice for the rest of my life, and I'm never going to touch a sweet again, Or on the other end of the extreme spectrum saying, oh, I'm gonna eat all the junk food I want and I'm gonna eat whatever I want because YOLO. So give me a dozen donuts and a whole pizza to myself because I deserve it. Anyways, so those extremes are bad. So finding that balance of eating healthy, eating my salads and my brown rice and my chicken breasts and my steaks and my bread and butter. Finding that balance is so much better than the extremes. Extremes on either end, healthy or unhealthy, are not good. The 28th thing I've learned in my life is to not fear aging, to enjoy life, and to age gracefully. To take care of myself in the process of getting older, physically, mentally, and spiritually. When I had my son a couple years ago, that's when aging and getting older really hit me. I was just like, oh my gosh, I'm not getting any younger. He's going to one day be 26 years old. This is insane. This is crazy. Anyways, just taking care of myself, taking care of my skin, taking care of my body with what I'm eating and exercise, of course, and the proper amount of sleep every single night. All those things are going to pay off, and I don't fear getting older. I look forward to it. I'm just going to enjoy my life, embrace my age. Just a reminder, everybody gets older. If you liked this video, please like, comment, subscribe, and of course, share. I am off to go and give myself a birthday pedicure. I will see you next time. Bye-bye.